This is Into Math 3rd Grade, Lesson 18.7. Solve 1 and 2-step problems using data. I can use data in picture graphs, bar graphs, and line plots to solve 1 and 2-step how many more and how many less problems. Please gather your workbook and a pencil and turn to page 481. We will start under Step It Out, Part 1. Pilar surveys the students in her group about their favorite summer activities. How many more students choose beach than pool and camp combined? Part A asks us to make a picture graph of the data. You may want to pause and go ahead and try to make the picture graph on your own and come back, or you're welcome to follow along with me. The first thing I'll do is put a title on the picture graph. It's favorite summer activity. Then I'm going to place the activities into the pictograph chart, all of the ones that I've typed in. You can do that as well. You can pause if you need to. And then I'm going to use the key down at the bottom that says a beach ball equals 2 students. And I'm going to take a look at the tally marks for each activity. And then write in the symbol on the pictograph. And when it is complete, it should look like this. Okay, now we're ready to look at Part B. Part B says, you can use the picture graph to solve the problem. Draw the symbols to compare these rows. And we're looking, we're comparing beach and pool and camp combined. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna look at beach. So here's beach. And beach has 5 symbols. So we're gonna go ahead and draw those in right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And pool has, here's pool. And pool has 2. So we're gonna draw those in, there's 2. And then camp has 1.5. So we're gonna need to draw 1.5. Okay, so once we've drawn in camp, we can now compare, taking a look at beach compared to pool and camp together. If we look at the think, beach has a whole beach ball and a half more than pool and camp combined. Now let's look at the next part of this question. What does a half of a symbol stand for in the graph? Well, we may need to go back again to the key that shows the whole beach ball represents 2 students, so half of the beach ball would represent 1 student. Let's take a look at Part C. What equations can you write to find how many more students choose beach than pool and camp combined? You may want to pause and try this part on your own and come back, or you can follow along with me. We know that beach has 5 balls and each ball represents 2 students. So for beach, we have 10 students. Now let's take a look at pool. Pool has 4 students because they have 2 balls with 2 students for each ball, and that's 4. That's for pool. And then we also have camp, which has 1 ball plus a half, which is 1, which is 3. So now we need to take pool and camp and add them together. So we have 4 plus 3, which makes 7. So now we can compare the beach activity to the total of pool and camp put together. So we can create an equation that compares 10, which is beach, take away 7, which is pool and camp, and we find the difference, which would be 3. So we can answer Part D, that 3 more students choose beach over pool, then camp combined. Let's turn to the next page, page 482, under Step It Out, Part 2. A store collects data about camping tent sales over 4 months. How many fewer tents were sold in March and April combined than in June? Okay, our first instruction tells us to make a bar graph of the data. So we look over and we see that at the top here, there's the camping tent sales, and then we have the month and the number of tents that were sold. And there's 4 months, March, April, May, and June. So first thing we're gonna do is make a title for camping tent sales. And then we are going to write the number sold on the bottom, and I made the number sold from 0 to 60, and my scale, or how it increases, goes up by 10. So you'll see that it goes 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. And then on the other side, I put the months, and I have June, May, April, and March. And then I use these labels and information to go ahead and make the bar graph for each month using the number sold. So March has 10, April has 15, May has 5, and June has 50. And you'll notice in April that the bar graph goes halfway between 10 and 20, representing 15. And then in May, it goes halfway between 0 and 10, which is 5. Now we can look at part B. One way to solve the problem is to use the bar graph. Compare the bars. They want us to count back from 50 to 25. So if our question is asking us for March and April combined and comparing that to June, then what we're doing with the bar graphs is we're taking March, which is 10, and April, which is 15, and we're putting them together. So we have 10 and 15, and then we're taking the June bar graph right here, which we know is 50, and we're putting them right next to each other. And so then we can see, oh, okay, when they're right next to each other like this, we see where they meet and where June goes past what April and March combined look like. So here's where they meet together, and then here's the rest. And we're trying to find out how many fewer tents were sold in March and April than in June. So we're going to start at the 50, and we're going to count back till we get to that line. So we're gonna go 10, 20, and we're gonna stop at right here, the midpoint, which would be 5, and that would be 25. So then we can answer that March and April combined have 25 fewer sales than June. And we use the bar graph to count backwards to find that out. Let's take a look at part C. Another way is to draw a bar model and write equations. So we know that March is 10. And so that's this number here, 10. And that April is 15. So that's this number right here. So when we combined March and April together, we're going to get 25, which is a written equation. We also know that June is 50. So we are going to take away the 25 from 50 and find the difference between 50 and 25, which is the difference between June and March and April. So you can pause and try that on your own and come back. And when you come back, you will find that 50 take away 25 is 25. Let's turn to the next page, page 483. Question 3. Kari measures the length of 9 pieces of used chalk to the nearest half inch. How many more chalk pieces have a length of 1.5 inches than lengths of 1/2 inch and 1 inch combined? Part A asks to make a line plot to show the data. If you would like to pause and try this on your own, you may do so or follow along with me. So we find that there is the chalk lengths in inches, and we have 9 measurements of the chalk lengths in this chart. So first thing we're going to do is make a title for our line plot. We label the line plot chalk lengths in inches. Next, we create the lengths and the scale on the number line for the plot line. And I have chosen to start with 0 and end at 3, and I increase every mark by 1/2 inch. So you may want to pause and write these numbers on your plot line. Then I'm going to take the data from the chart that we have right here, and I'm going to place an X over each measurement, one for every measurement that's on the chart. Now I can take a look at Part B. Part B says, use the line plot to solve the problem. Draw X's to compare the columns of X's. You may want to try this part on your own. I'm showing here that 1/2 inch has 1x, and 1 inch has 2x's. Now I'm going to take a look at 1.5 inches, where I find that there are 5 X's for 1.5 inches. Now I can compare 1.5 inch compared to 1.5 inches. There are 2 more X's for 1.5 inches. So I can write that into Part B. Let's take a look at Part C. What equations can you write to compare the X's? How many more chalk pieces have a length of 1.5 inches than the lengths of 1/2 inch and 1 inch combined? We see that the 1/2 inch and 1 inch combined would be 1 + 2, which makes 3. And then when we're comparing the 1.5 inches to the combined, we know that 1.5 inches is 5. And so we're taking away the combination of 1.5 inch and 1/2 inch. And when we take away 3, we get the answer of 2. So we know the answer is 2 more chalk pieces. If you would like to go back and watch this video, you can do so at any time and pause along the way as needed.